Split testing, or A/B testing, is a type of strategy that you can use on your audience to test different content and see how they perform better with slight changes. Not only can it show you what your followers want most, but it gives you insights on how they react to different types of content, allowing you to strategize better. Marketers use this method all the time, in their websites, in their blogs. Sometimes they'll send out different versions of emails to test on their customers, for example. Today we're going to use this in Twitter. We'll discuss how to segment our audiences by time zones, we'll create a split test, and show you some examples of results to analyze as well. So to begin, we schedule our content into different pipelines of information with Tweepsmap's post calendar. It allows us to gain insight on how often we post about a certain kind of tweet. For example, we use our pipelines to separate Twitter news from social media news. We have posts optimized in Asia and Australia, Europe and the Middle East, and for the Americas. We also have a pipeline for all of our Twitter threads. Separating our content by time zones ensures that we post during everyone's peak activity hours with an international audience in mind. And since Twitter doesn't work on a linear timeline, our Australian followers, for example, won't see what our European followers will, unless you're looking at our page from top to bottom. This is because 6,000 tweets get posted every second, meaning that your posts are going to virtually fade away in moments. Now, there's a lot more you can do with pipelines, and since everyone's audience is different, visit our blog linked in the description so you can find out more ways to strategize. So let's get into our split test. After you segment your content into different time zones, you can now test your tweets without spamming your audience. The example for our split test are two tweets promoting our last YouTube video on 6 ways to get new Twitter followers. Each post in the test shared the same hashtags, so the only difference was the delivery of the message and the video clips attached. The first one was about posting during peak active times, and the second one was about trying different content and using a free tool. We tracked the performance of each post with our engagement dashboard, and this allowed us to see how they measured against each other. But it's important to know that you should wait around a week to surely understand the results of your efforts. For example, the first post talked about how to optimize your posting times for a higher outreach, while the second post mentioned how to vary your content to understand your audience, and it mentioned a free tool. The second post had more profile clicks, which might correlate to the free tool mentioned in the video. This is because our audience is probably inclined to get that tool through our profile. This means that if you want to funnel people from your Twitter to your website, you can mention what free benefits you can offer so they're inclined to try it for themselves. On the other hand, if I was going for brand awareness, for example, I would stick to sharing a quick tip like our first tweet so our audience can learn something quickly in their busy days. Although this was a quick and simple example, you can see that we now have a better idea on how our audience reacts to different information so that we can strategize our tweets depending on our goals. Now, there are no definitive answers and everyone's following is different, so just remember to give your tests a little bit more time so your results are clearer. Have any questions? Let me know in the comments below. If you want to try this strategy for yourself, sign up for Tweepsmap, where you can use all of our free features to get started. Also, check out the blog linked in the description if you want more detail on what we discussed. If you learned something today, give it a like and share it with someone who might benefit as well. And as always, thank you so much for watching.